I live in the house that I grew up in. You know, as a young boy, all the family was here, my grandfather, my uncle, great uncles. There was a lot going on here with all those people and the business as it was at that time. And for a young farm boy, this was hog heaven. And I never dreamed that I would do anything else.
My dad actually never said, come out here, don't come out here. He pretty much gave me the story that I give my kids, is you can be what you want, just whatever you do, do it right, and you know, be smart.
The Renks came from Germany in 1846. The Renk Seed Company was incorporated in 1936. The corporation was formed by my grandfather, William F. Renk, and his three sons, Walter F. Renk, Wilbur N. Renk, and Robert F. Renk.
Well, the Depression hit in that late 20s, early 30s. At that point, they graduated, and they wanted to come back out to the farm. Money was tight, and it's like, for them to stay out on the farm, they had to come up with a way that made them happy, made their dad happy. And so they came up with the idea to incorporate.
And that was the first farm family corporation in the United States. And in 1968, myself, my brother John Renk, who was Alex's father, and my cousin Stephen Renk, we purchased the corporation. And the transition was made very generously by our fathers and uncles. Historically, Renk did a lot of things other than seed products. We were in livestock, very well known for livestock. Other crops, dairy cows, pigs, cattle. The last cattle left here in 1992. And since then, our whole focus has been the seed business. I think there's been a long history in the family of being very forward-thinking, being amenable to passing the corporation or the farm on to the next generation, which in a lot of German families doesn't happen so easily.
And it might be a philosophy that we have without even really realizing it is a business model of stewardship. I don't feel like this is my business. Yeah, you know, it's yours to run for a while. Then it'll be somebody else's time, but it's not yours.
Basically, I started working from when I was 11. My first job on the farm was I was working the dryer. When I was not in school, I was usually working.
I was 9 and I was mowing lawns for my grandfather. I mean, you get to know a man working with him. You really do. He was a taskmaster, I'll tell you. I mean, I got to spend time with, you know, two generations of the line. Him and his brother set the standard for my dad and his generation as well, and including myself.
When my generation was in college, we were asked to spend one summer working for one of the other family members instead of just working for your dad all the time. I worked in the sales group one summer. I worked in the research group one summer. We got a pretty broad look at what was going on, and out of that mix, I chose research. And that's where I worked my first 20 years here in the business.
Or when I actually went into college, I said, I'm not coming back here. I had the agricultural background, I had enough brains to be an engineer. I graduated with that degree, and so I came back. I'm glad I came back.
And so another generation has been transitioned into this business. And I am chairman of the board, but they're effectively running the company.
The president, vice president, secretary, treasurer thing doesn't really make a bit of difference to any of us. You know, we're more directors of certain things than anything else. I handled the IT department, our marketing, the office, and the soybean alfalfa selection for our company.
The research gave me tremendous product knowledge. It gave me a lot of credibility. It gave me a lot of hands-on experience of being in the field with these products. I don't have to think twice. The recommendations we make are sound. It gives you tremendous, I think, tremendous power when you're in front of our potential customers.
We are not real big on formal titles here, so You know, my job is the production end of things. It's my job to, you know, get it made, get it created, and get into a package that we can get out to our customers.
I just kind of oversee the big picture. And when you get older, of course, it's an adjustment. They don't have to do everything I say because I realize that diverse opinions are what makes the company go. We don't all have to think the same way or talk the same way or walk the same way.
We've avoided the strong figurehead. We've avoided that there's one family member who is either a CEO or a president who has some power or control over the others. And so it forces you to work together and to get along.
All members of the family are very competent, well-educated. We've worked together for a long time. It does help, too, that Dad's still around to kind of ride herd on it.
I can't certainly take care of credit for all of it. I mean, my brother was involved, my cousin was involved. We were a team, just as Jeff and Brett and Alex are a team. And we all work together and come up with these ideas, and we hash them out in the boardroom. I mean, we don't function in isolation. We function as a team.
So there has to be communication. There has to be cooperation. Otherwise, the whole thing goes nowhere. We are very, very close to the people in the field, the eventual consumer of our product. We take a lot of pride in that. It means a lot to us. I think it means a lot to our customers.
You almost have to come to one of our annual meetings or annual conventions to understand what's going on. There's people that have been dealers with us 30, 40, 50 years. And it's not an arm's length transaction, it's family. And you know, that's one of the reasons for success in our corporation.
There's a very strong presence now in seed industry of some very large chemical corporations. As those large corporations have come in and taken over more and more of the seed business and put their stamp on how they're going to run the business, farmers have not responded well to that relationship.
They're still doing it the old-fashioned way, where you actually have to boots on the ground, be on the farm, and talk to these farmers one-on-one. And these farmers appreciate you making an extra effort to come to their farm, because they just don't want to be another number.
Farmers don't like to see a different person every year to do business with. They like to see the same guy every year. And they like to see what you make when you make a promise you deliver.
Any of our customers or our dealers, if they have a problem, they can pick up the phone, call the office. A real person will answer, and you can be talking to a Renk in 30 seconds.
We got seven generations behind us. That has shown us, I think, over time, is that it's a personal relationship business. To this day, people want to buy from people that they trust, that they can believe. That's basically our philosophy.
And I'll tell you too that, I mean, there's nobody out there that has a toy in their plant or a new piece of equipment or a more technologically advanced stuff that we have. You've got all the best equipment. You've got all the best things. Go out there and do your best work.
Everybody believes in what we're doing. Everybody is engaged with, the people that produce are engaged with the people that grow. A lot of other organizations don't have that.
Talk about business plans, mission statements. Those things drive me nuts, because doing things right, you know, having good products, delivering them, you know, maintaining the relationships that you have with your distributors and your customers. Those are what we look for, you know, and that's kind of the model we follow.
I think our legacy will be that we've taken all the facets of the business, the product management, the sales group, the production, and we've created something that's maybe a little bit bigger than the sum of its parts.
You wind up with this group of people, and everybody cares about everybody else, and like I say, the connection is much stronger.
If generations were looking down at us, probably the two big things that they'd be most proud of is the fact that we're still here. We've pretty much retained
you know, the land and added to it, I think they'd be very proud of that. You can't always say that about a lot of companies.
And it is a family business, and it is a relationship business. And it's much more than just, you know, just the family. I mean, the dealers that have been with us, I mean, I knew some of their grandfathers and grandfathers, these guys. And you know what, it's way bigger than us.
I think if anything I've learned throughout life, and it's not about money or anything else, it's family, friends, and loved ones. Those are the things that are important in life. And I include our employees and our dealer organization, our customers, as some of our friends. Everything else is secondary. If you've got those things, you're a very wealthy person.